Hi, and welcome back to Lesson 3 of Spreadsheets for Business. In Lesson 3, we'll learn how to use Excel 2013 to effectively display our data using Excel's charting capabilities. In the third video of Level 1, we'll continue to analyze the various chart types available to us. More specifically, we'll work with the area charts and pie charts. Additionally, we'll demonstrate how to create and edit series names, as well as how to use data labels on these two types of charts. Let's start off with the same data that we used in our previous videos, the sales data for these years for the three categories of products. For this data, we previously generated a column chart here on the left, as well as a line chart here on the right. Each of these visualizes the data in a slightly different way, and there's actually the chart type that combines the best features of both of these two, and that's called the area chart. We can create the area chart using the wizard like we've been doing, by just highlighting all of the data like so, insert, area chart, and then pick the 2D one here for simplicity. But let's build it a little bit differently to get you more familiar with the more powerful and flexible way of creating your charts. Anybody can use the wizard, but that doesn't teach you anything about how to fix something if the wizard doesn't do exactly what you'd hoped it did in the first place, does it? So there is a more powerful and flexible way of building a chart from scratch, but it involves a little extra knowledge, but that's what you're here for, right? Let's highlight the first header row here, along with the row of equipment sales, go to Insert, and then this icon here to create an area chart. We'll start with the basic two-dimensional one here. See now how the top of the area chart follows the same contour as our line chart? But with this area underneath that's now color-coded? Not amazed yet? Well, let's add another area or series to this chart then. Go here to Select Data. Up here we have the current data chart range of A4 to I5. Here on the left part are the list of the current series. We only have the equipment series currently, so let's add the footwear series along with it. Click on the Add. For the series name, we select the cell containing the category name of footwear, A6. For the series values, delete what's in that current text box, and then select the data corresponding to the footwear sales, and hit OK. See our chart data range is now A4 to I6? The sixth row contains the footwear data, doesn't it? Well, if we want our apparel sales in row 7 on here as well, what would happen if we just go up into that data range and backspace over the 6 and then type in a 7? How cool is that? You've got to be impressed now. Another way to add data to our chart. So this is a pretty good visualization and uses lots of color and tells a pretty clear story, right? There are some potential problems in the underlying data that can keep this chart from being used as much as you'd think. If you look at the data values for equipment, they are always greater than the footwear, and the footwear is always greater than the apparel. What happens if we increase some of the footwear sales figures out here? Change this one, change this one. See what happens to our areas? Equipment disappears behind the footwear, and we lose track of what the equipment sales even are. We can further confuse things if we have a spike in apparel sales here in that last year. The takeaway from this is that the area chart only works ideally if the data in each data series are greater than all the subsequent series. The next chart that we're going to explore is the pie chart. A pie chart is useful when you want to show the relative contribution as a percentage of each category as it relates to the whole or 100% of the series. Here in Figure 3.13 is an example of a pie chart showing the relative contribution of each of the category sales to the entire sales for the year 2016. This is a 2D pie chart that has a legend here of 1, 2, and 3. That information is not terribly helpful, is it? Whoever created this chart didn't include the category names over here, probably because they didn't know what they were doing in the first place. But you'll be smarter than that, won't you? If you want to create a pie chart where the categories are separated from the data by a few columns like we have here in this data, you can still create the pie chart by selecting the three categories and then hold the Control key down and then at the same time select the 2016 data. Then click on Insert, and then select the pie chart of your choice over here. And there you go. If we wanted to show off rather than making a new chart the correct way, we can just fix this first attempt by selecting that chart. And then you can either right click on the chart and click Select Data here, or click on the Design tool up here and then select Data. See over here in the horizontal or category axis labels, we see the worthless values of 1, 2, and 3. Let me click on Edit over there, and we get a pop-up that lets us define what goes in there. Let me select my three category names and hit OK. It looks like we're well on our way to improving this chart. Let's finish showing off by adding a series name to the data source. See here, it's just called Series 1 over here in the left-hand pane. Let me select that one and click on the Edit button. The Edit Series window appears, and there's nothing in the series name. When there's nothing here, Excel just calls it the infinitely uninformative Series 1. I'll click in this text box and then select the cell containing the year for our sales data of 2016, or cell I4. A sometimes useful feature of the pie chart is that the segments are movable. For example, I can select this footwear section and drag it out. This is sometimes a way of accentuating a certain important piece of the pie. The last thing that I want to add to this chart is to add data labels. There are several ways to do this. You can go up here to Design, and then Add Chart Element, and then select Data Labels, and we see a bunch of choices here. We can also go back to the chart itself, right-click on the pie, and select Data Labels. This may or may not be the exact style of labels that we want, so we can edit these by clicking on this plus sign, selecting Data Labels, clicking on this small arrow here, and then selecting More Options, which opens up this big side panel over here with a myriad of options. Here we can choose the series or category name, the value, the percentage, as well as any separator that you would want between each of our different label parts. You can also adjust the position of the labels somewhere inside or outside of the pie. Let me undo all of this to get back to my basic pie. Notice that when we had the entire pie selected and instructed Excel to add labels, it added labels to each slice of the pie, and the menu even said the plural data labels with an S. If we go back here and select just one slice of the pie, and then right-click that slice, we now get the phrase data label, no S, singular. This gives us the power to create and or edit the label for that one particular slice of the pie. This singular plural data label data labels functionality works on all different chart types within Excel 2013. We now have a truly excellent pie chart. That's it for now. See you in the next video.